today's video. So not a video I ever wanted to make, but as the title suggests, my Instagram account has been stolen. The purpose of this video really is to let people know what happened. I'm going to link my new Instagram account in the description box of this video, and then just also talk a little bit about how it's going to affect things, and specifically the release of the next album that I'm doing. And whilst we're on the topic of the next album though, I'm going to the video at the start of this, the playing clip and the video at the end, and I might put one in the middle as well. I'm going to dot some preview playing clips from the demos from album 2, just to kind of keep some guitar content in here really. I wouldn't necessarily want to subject anyone to a video of purely me talking for 10 minutes or whatever this video might turn out to be. So basically what happened last weekend, I was on a Skype lesson with a student, my phone started ringing, I started getting text messages, the landline started ringing, I started getting Facebook messages as well, and basically people were saying, you need to check your Instagram, I think you've been hacked, I've just had this weird message come through. So sure enough, I went to check Instagram and I'd been logged out, I couldn't get back in again, my password had been changed, and from what people were showing me, it looked as though a post had gone up on my page, something to do with either Bitcoin or PayPal, and that post had been sent, as far as I can tell, to all my followers. And a similar post had also gone up on my story, or something of a similar nature anyway. And this, it was really worrying, because someone essentially has control of your voice, posting content that you don't want posting, that you've got no affiliation with or no association with. And not cool. But I was trying to do everything I could to get it back, and they changed all the reset codes. So every time I got a new code, it was going to them. So they just changed the password. And this carried on the whole day, and they were changing the username at the time. So when I had control of the account, it was James Franklin Guitar. It went to a few iterations of that throughout the day whilst I was trying to get it back, and they were then changing the username. The next day, however, I looked back and all the content had been wiped, all 600 videos. The bio had been changed, the profile picture had been changed, and the name was something completely different. And it looked as though it's been completely wiped and then sold on for someone else to use as a blank account with 22,000 followers, essentially. So, and it's not looking like there's anything I can do to get it back. So this is going to affect a few things, but specifically the release of the next album. At this point, it's pretty much all written, it's all demoed, and I'm actually meeting with Posh Croc Studios later this week to listen through the demo tracks, decide on what guitars we'll use, what amps, that kind of thing. And I'm still going to record it now. I don't want to postpone the recording of it, but I am going to postpone the release, as I've now lost a platform with which to promote the album and let people know it's coming out. So I'm going to hang on a little bit until I can get numbers up on the new account. So the handle of my new Instagram account is James Franklin Official. In all honesty, I wasn't overly keen on the name. The name of the having official at the end of it, kind of, I feel like that should maybe be for super famous people. But as there was an unofficial account with my name attached to it for a while, I thought it might be appropriate, but also there wasn't much choice available that went with my name. So James Franklin Official is the new account. So that's where I'll be posting from now on. And as soon as I've got a date for the next album, I'll put it on there. I'd be really grateful to anyone who wouldn't mind having a look at that page and maybe giving it a follow if you like what's on there. But if you just let a few videos play out and click like, that kind of thing, it would really help out the initial performance of the page, and hopefully I can get back on track as soon as possible. So another area I'm really going to notice an impact, I've essentially lost my online business card, and as a freelance guitarist, there's an awful lot of kind of behind the scenes, almost like sales pitch emails, where you're trying to network with people, and whether it's for gear demos or recording on tracks, remote session work, that kind of thing. And it's having an Instagram account is fairly pivotal in a situation like that. As far as the companies that I currently endorse and work with are concerned, they've all been amazing about it and really understanding and really helpful. And where it is going to make things a little bit harder is reaching out to new companies. Not having an Instagram page is quite often one of the, not always, but quite often one of the prerequisites to kind of a working partnership is having an Instagram page with traffic on there. So it is going to make things a little bit harder on that front. But in light of everything that's going on, realistically, a hacked Instagram account is fairly trivial. I'm not trying to be all doom and gloom about it. As I say, this video is just to let people know what's going on, really. So I'm going to get back at it, the new page, try and get things back on track as soon as possible. But I just want to say a huge thank you to everyone who's been in touch, everyone I spoke to over the past week, because everyone has genuinely been amazing. There's been so many messages of support and help and advice, and it's all just so appreciated. Family, friends, previous followers, the companies I work with, everyone has been really, really helpful. And I just want to say a really big thank you. And one of the other things I'm going to find really hard about this is that I've been doing these YouTube videos for 2 years now, and at the end of every one, I've said, if you've got any questions, message me at James Franklin Guitar, which is, at this point, almost muscle memory. So to retrain myself to say, at James Franklin Official, might take a little while. But if you've got any questions, send me a message at James Franklin Official. Nearly got it wrong then. Or you can obviously let me know in the comments section. But again, just thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it, and it really does mean a lot. Take care, and I will see you in the next video.